to bless us. But we are here not to bless everyone, but to bless the Lord. Rather than God. God is the only way, the truth, and the life. The only God who sees everything. The one who deserves our service, the Lord. And today, actually, I heard that we are going to celebrate Workers' Appreciation Day, right? All over the world, I think that churches are celebrating Workers' Appreciation Month. And we would like to honor your worker, or workers, rather, in giving their lives the best time in serving the Lord through the church. And I'm very honored to be here, giving encouragement to our pastor, our leaders, the leaders of the church who are faithfully serving the Lord all your life. Wala namang magaling eh, kundi si Lord lang po eh. No one is really good. Only God. So let's pray. We thank you, Lord, for such an opportunity for us to serve you. To give you all the glory, all that we have, all that we are. I just feel your presence that I'm here in this place. And I pray, Father, that you continue to fill this place in your love, with your presence. And in your presence, you said in your word that there is fullness of joy. And I pray, Father, that as we serve you, may that joy overflows in our hearts. This morning, I pray that every soul, every spirit who are here, you move every one of us here, Father. And you bring us, Lord, to that high level of faith, so that when we go up in this place, Father, we are filled with your anointing, filled with your presence. Like Moses, he said on that mount, he said, Lord, I will not leave this place if you will not go with us. So today, as we start our listening to your word, as we start being filled with your word, Lord, set our spirit right, set our mind right, set our body right, in receiving the blessings from your word. This we pray in the mighty name of our Lord, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And everybody say, amen. Amen. Come on, let's give a hand to the Lord of God. The premise of my message is about servanthood. And God said, we serve God by serving others. In fact, the question is, how do you measure? Wait, is it somebody in hand? T-shirt po kasi medyo emotional po si pastor na yan. I don't know why. T-shirt lang po. Salamat. Thank you to your Jonathan. How do you think, or how do you measure greatness? Because if we ask the world, they measure greatness with how much you possess. They measure greatness what is your status in life, right? They measure greatness with power and authority, right? How do you measure greatness? Jesus, however, measured greatness by your service. Everybody say service. Jesus measures greatness by our service. In fact, he will measure greatness not how many people serve you, but how many people you serve. Gaano pa karami ang pinaglilingkuran natin?
hindi gaano karami yung nagsiserve sa atin. That's how God measures our greatness. But the world that we have, the world that we are living in, somewhat opposite. You should be a leader. You should be great so that people will serve you. And people who are fighting for that position to be served. That's what the world is. That's what the world is displaying, the power that we should have. That's the contrary, and the opposite teaching of the Bible. Actually, even the disciples more than 2,000 years ago were arguing. They argued who will sit on the right and on the left. These are disciples already. Nobody wants to be servant. Everybody wants to lead. Actually, if you walk to a library or bookstore, you will find thousands of books published, written, talks about leadership. But there are few books written about servanthood. And it's important to know what can we offer. What is your shape? Can you look at the person next to you? Look at the shape. What is your shape? What is your talent? I'm not talking about the size of families. Okay? I'm talking about what do you have? What do you think God put in you to serve Him? What do you have? Some people say, I have talent. I know how to sing. I know how to dance. I know how to play music. But what if you don't have those things? You're not going to serve the Lord. What else do we have that you think God put in you that you can serve God well? We need to find a shape that God formed us for us to fit. Actually, there are some quotations that you cannot put round peg in a square, or you cannot put square peg in a round hole. It should be fit in serving the Lord. But you know, sometimes God will put you in a situation, in a place where you don't have any gifts, but you have to serve the Lord. For example, sometimes you don't need, actually, you don't need to be talented to stay for a while after service and taking up those garbage for you to make, or stacking the chair. Right? How many of you here? I'm not going to stack the chair. I'm not going to form or I'm going to arrange the table. I don't have gift. Hello? Ayoko naman ganun, maglinis ng kusina. Wala akong kingdom eh. Kasi dito may mga third eye, mga ma'am, kailan daw may third eye? Kailan nakakita ng dumi sa kusina? At yung mga anak, I don't have gift, ma'am. You know, sometimes God will put you in a place where you can serve God no matter who you are, no matter who you are, in serving the Lord. Your shape reveals your ministry. And that's true. This coming months, probably, you will be having a lecture and you will choose people who will fit a position. Your shape reveals your ministry according to your skill. But listen, but your servant's heart reveals your maturity. Let me repeat that. Your shape reveals your ministry, but your servant's heart will reveal your maturity. Jesus said, Matthew 7:20, you can tell what they are by what they do. Yes, just as you can identify a tree by its fruit, so you can identify people by their action. So today's message is about honoring God with your service.
real servant act? How do you think a real, a genuine servant act? Number one, I want you to write it down. If you have your notes with you, if you have pen, if you have cell phones, you can take out the notes and don't go to FB, don't go to Reels, TikTok. Okay,
number one,
real servants make themselves available. Everybody say available.
Available.
Are you available to serve? Because real servants make themselves available. They are like soldiers. They're ready to jump in right away if they are called to serve. There's no excuses because they're trained to serve right away no matter what. There's no string that holds them back. Because they
committed
in serving like a soldier. It says here in Timothy chapter 4, no soldier in active service entangles himself in the affairs of everyday life so that he may please the one who enlisted him. Anything that will hold a person, a soldier, in serving, hindi niya nag-engage. He doesn't want to engage in those things that will hold them in serving God because they were called to serve. Like us, in serving God, are you available in serving the Lord? Take this down. If we only serve when it's convenient for us, we are not a real servant. Wow, that's powerful. If we only serve when it's convenient for us, we are not real servant. Number two, real servants do what is needed even when it's inconvenient. And you turn to the person next to you, ask the person, are you available? Come on. Are you available? Yes, I'm single. Hindi mo yun ang tanong, please. Ang keep ko lang sa... Yes, I'm single. And ready to meet you. Okay. Are you available? Because as a servant, whenever God calls them to serve, they put themselves on the line. Are you willing? Listen, what if God messed up your schedule? What is your character? How do you deal with it? Oh, we have an appointment. But God sent you somebody who is in need, who needs your service. You're driving and somebody, you saw a person who is having a hard time fixing their tire. And you're driving home. That's sad. I don't want to experience that today. But you're a believer. What will you do? Will you give a hand? Or you're thinking of your appointment? That's the real servant. Servant's heart is ready to do what is needed, even when it is inconvenient. We don't choose or pick time to serve. God will put you in a situation where you have to choose whether you serve Him or walk away. The antidote for this is this. When you wake up now in the morning as a servant, this is the mindset. Lord, I will remind myself, I am your servant. I'm willing for you. Willing and giving you the authority to mess up my schedule. Yes, we have a schedule. We have appointments. We organize our life. But what if God, again, because He is God, He controls everything, right? And He puts you in a place where you are facing somebody who needs your help. Are you willing to serve? Because serving God is serving. Some people think, many Christians think that serving God is only in the four corners of the church. Well, do you serve God? Oh yeah, I serve God in the music ministry. I serve God in men's and women's, in our youth ministry.
Real servants pay attention to needs. They look up at me. They're very much aware of what's going on around. If they see the need, they feel the need. Galatians 6:10, whenever we have the opportunity, we have to do what is good for everyone. Especially for the family of believers. Right? There was one time I was, we visited somebody at the hospital, and there was a young man with his, I think it was, what do you call it? He had an accident, probably because his one foot was cast. And I passed by, and God from something, an impression that the Holy Spirit was wanted to do. And he said, you know what? Go back and pray for the person. Lord, I don't know. Even me, I'm a pastor already. And I said, Lord, I don't know that person. Why do you have that impression that I have to go back and pray for that person? If you're in that situation, what will you do? You don't know the person, and you need to follow that impression that the Holy Spirit is trying to do. So you went back, and I said, do you mind if I pray for you? He said, yes, sure. Nothing there can happen. But at least you follow the impression of the Holy Spirit. You pray for the prayer. You don't know what's going to happen next. Amen. All we have to do is just follow. We are not the one doing the miracle. It's the Lord. Amen. And who knows when he went home? We don't know. But at least you see the need. You feel the need. But sometimes people are stubborn. Even Christians. The Bible says in Proverbs 27:28, never tell your neighbor to wait until tomorrow if you can help them now. That's hard. When somebody asks you, how are you? All of a sudden, these friends of yours, you know, no one was back. The next thing is what? The kind of man. Sana all. And here's the thing. What will we do? Are we gonna pass? Or next time? It's hard actually. Because those thoughts that we have, don't just give sometimes. What about those people on the street who knock at their window and we just roll down? I don't have anything here. Or we just ignore it. We don't look at them. What is our attitude? The Bible says, never tell your neighbors to wait until tomorrow. That means you had to do something right away. There was one time we were praying for one of our members in the same group where I was a part of the prayer share. And one of our members shared, he said, you know what, I need, he mentioned an exact amount that he needed for his brother. And we as a group, all right, the initial reaction is, let's pray for that. Let's pray. Pray that, and after that, what's next? And God impressed me in my heart something. You know what? I think we can do something with your prayer request. Why don't we share right away so that our prayers are already answered by God? Right there, amen. And sometimes when we pray and then we do nothing, it's the same thing. Somebody mentioned a need. And you heard the need, and it's good to pray. But after prayer, what's next? If you have something that you can share, that you can
do para tukunan yung need, so that that person can say and declare, God is really good. Why? During the time of prayer, God answered right away. Amen. Because of that servant heart. Sometimes we consider prayer right away as an answer. Prayer is a tool. Amen. It's just a tool to bring the message to God, but the answer actually, probably, God will use you. There was a pastor, and they have a project, a church building, and he said, he announced, mga kapatid, I have good and bad news this morning. What do you want first, good or bad? He said, good, pastor. All right, our project, our church building, God already answered it. He already sent money for the church building, palakpakan niyo mga tao, katulad ng palakpakan niyo, come on. Okay. Ganyan. Now, sabi mga member, now, Pastor, what's the bad news? The bad news is, God said, you will be used to provide that answer. Sa inyo, itong ipapataan yung sagot. Tumahinig yung mga tao. Oh, wow, talaga. What is our attitude when God said yes to your need and the tool or the, what do you call it, the material to be used for answering that prayer is us? How are we going to say, Lord, I'm not available. Lord, use that person, not me, not ever, not now. John Wesley said, do all the good you can. By all means you can. In all the ways you can. In all the places you can. At all times you can. To all the people you can. As long as you ever can. And if that's the attitude of every believer, walang hopeless. Walang need. Lahat makikater natin yung need. Walang masama ang loob, because everybody works hand in hand all together. Hindi naman kailangan magaling. You don't need to have a very full force of resources, filled of talent. All we have to do is just pagsama-samahin those small resources and the need will be met. That is greatness. When you think that doing these small things, yung maliliit na bagay na ginawa-gawa natin, you think that this is great things for God. Amen. You know, wiping the table after you eat, putting back all the chairs after recent service, you don't need talent for that. But if everybody is doing that, mas magaan. Amen po ba? When you still have time, you go early and helping, fixing everything. Now that you move in a place where you don't, you have to be early to set up everything, do it. We are not here to go and, Lord, I want you to bless me. But instead, Lord, I want to go there to bless you by blessing others. Amen. And if that's the attitude of that kind of heart, a servant heart, man, people will come, people will serve, and people will have joy in their heart in serving. Number four, real servants do their best with what they have. They don't procrastinate. When they procrastinate, magaling ang Pinoy dyan. Yung naghihintay na tamang pagkakataon. Hindi ko namin kung gagawin ang panahon.
busy procrastinating, make excuses, wait for better circumstances. Kapag saka na pag meron tayong budget. And those are, you know, reasonable excuses sometimes. But what the Bible say? Ecclesiastes chapter 11 verse 4. It says, the Bible says, if you wait for perfect conditions, you will never get anything done. That's what the Bible is saying. You know, sometimes people, it's not bad, you know, to think in advance. Hindi na natin kung talaga possible. You know, physical study. But when you wait too long, you will never accomplish anything. Amen. Because there are ways to step right away and do what you can for God's glory, for God's grace. If you wait for perfect conditions, you will never get anything done. And when they do things, they do their best. You don't need to be excellent, but rather give what you have. And what you have, do your best. Sometimes our best, I guess the best wasn't good enough. Do you hear something? I did my best, but I sometimes for people to serve the Lord. Oh, I'm not good in singing, I'm not good in serving, I'm not good in building. Actually, lahat ng nakakawakot ko, nababasag. Pero maganda dito. Lahat ng ginagawa ko, palpak. I'm not good in anything. No. What you have, what you do, just give your best. And sometimes your best, probably not good for somebody. Amen, right? But it's okay. Why? Because what? Who are we serving? We are serving God, not man. Amen. Can we give a big hand to the Lord God? So don't wait for your talent to be perfect. All you need is your availability, your willingness, your teachable heart. That when somebody approach you, kapatid, that's not how we do it. That's not how we do it. So, you ask the trainee or asking them how to do it well. And then you learn slowly, day by day. Actually, what most of us started in a very simple way. Amen. Church, thank you. Your number is good. How old is the church? How old is the church? 4 years?
And thank you, God.
As big as you are, you started. How many? 10 to 34. Some started playing instruments in a very simple way. Your equipment started in a very simple way, right? Simple setup. And then you had your in-ear setup. Now you move to another place and you're back to simple setup again. It's okay. Don't be discouraged. Because there is a learning process. You know, some are, when you move, probably people are moving to also to different places. It's okay. Don't lose heart. As long as you have Christ, as long as you have God, you're good. And slowly God will fill your heart with that joy serving God. Because we're not serving God because of that person. We're not serving God because of that pastor. We are serving God because God is worthy. very much potential in your church. I see much potential in your church. You have much people than us. And if you have that much, you can turn Lloydminster up and down. You have families, relatives, co-workers, schoolmates, and friends that you can serve well with your life. Number five, real servants do every task with equal dedication. And this is hard here in Canada. You know, some people came here to Canada not because of the church, but because of family, because of work. Amen. And church sometimes is not their priority. So that when they are part of the church, commitment is really, really challenging. It's hard to commit. So the question is, a servant, we have to do every task with equal dedication. When you are dedicated to your family, you are dedicated to your work, we should also dedicate it to God. Amen. And through the church, we serve God. This is because this is more the place that where more spiritual activities happen. The Bible says, Galatians 6:3, if you think you are too important to help someone in need, you are only fooling yourself. You are really a nobody. Don't think that as a servant of God, you're kind of somebody. Now, if you're not there, people are not functioning. If that's the character of a servant, people will fight for that position, people will fight for that faith, for that authority and power. Do you have equal dedication when it comes to serving God? Small act, small service, if you think that is great things for God. Magiging dedicated ka ba if what you're doing is a very simple act? There was back in Louisiana. Pero dito, Louisiana, Laguna, where your pastor and I came. We had this guy, he's not actually normal like us. He is a Down syndrome guy. And you know what he is? Every Sunday he does in the church. He goes early in the morning. He's the first person to go to church. The text na uuna pa doon sa nagbubukas ng gate. Anong ginagawa niya? He makes sure that those Bibles, he arranged those Bibles, the pews, those are our chairs, our pews. Then, pag praise and worship, walang pwedeng humawak ng tamburin. Sa kanya lang yung tamburin. Nasa harap siya. Makikita mo yung kanyang tempo is opposite. Opposite siya. Awkward, if you look at it. But people are happy to see that guy. He's a Down syndrome guy. Small things affects the congregation. And the dedication, the commitment is there. Size of the task is irrelevant. No matter you are the chairman of the board, the vice chairman of the board, or the least of the group. All of us here, listen, are servants of God. Walang itong audience. Lahat mo dito, when you came into the church this morning, we are all performers. Amen. Nobody should be pleased but God. So when we perform, whether it's large, big, huge, or small, our attitude should be, Lord, this is for you. And I'm not here to please somebody, but to please you.
sa trabaho, if you're early going to your work, you're also early going to church, serving God. Amen. Because it is God that we serve, that we worship. I don't know how long or how far is your house, but actually, sa totoo lang, pag mga Pinoy, kung sino yung malapit, sino na yung malapit. Bakit ganon, no? Bakit ganon? Kung sino yung nasa tapat na lang church, sino yung late? Madalas ganon. No. We will change that. The culture. Amen? The culture that we have, should have is that, Lord, no matter how far, no matter how near, no matter how big or small my service is, I will give my 100% dedication. Equal dedication to you. Actually, great opportunities disguise themselves in small tasks. Those small tasks are just in disguise for better and greater opportunities. My wife, when we landed here in Canada, Winnipeg, she didn't have a work permit yet. So she waited for at least 3 months because we applied for a work permit for her. So what she did, she volunteered because our building apartment, the next building to us, is a home care. So what she did, she volunteered. So she go there cleaning the mess hall, arranging chairs for the elderly. And 3 months, she's doing that. And the manager noticed her. Who are you? Oh, I'm volunteering here. Since when? Oh, it's been 3 months. What? I never see you here. Because she's, you know, madalang mo siya visited the or very rare na mag-visit sa home care because she runs different home cares. Okay, tomorrow, go to my office and I will give you a job. It happens to many people who are volunteering themselves here. Once they notice your dedication, your commitment, it's a door to greater opportunity. Amen. And say this to the Lord, what you do serving God with small tasks, it's just a disguise for greater opportunities. Number three, number six. We only have 24, so sorry. Number six. Real servants are faithful. Everybody say faithful. Faithful to their ministry. They're dedicated. They give 100% their best. Equal dedication. Faithful. This is sometimes hard. Sometimes, in serving the Lord, there's so many things happening in our lives that we have to make a choice. And I don't know where you are right now. Servants, listen, finish their task. They fulfill. They fulfill their responsibilities and they complete their commitment. Sometimes when we face challenges in life, it's easy to leave our job half undone. Some disciples did that when they realized that God was not with them anymore. When Christ, he died on the cross, and he's resurrected, and they were so afraid. What they did, they went back to their jobs, to their secular jobs, to their community. They saw nothing opportunities left for them because Christ is not. Sometimes with God, or with us serving the Lord, when we are
facing trials, problems in life, challenges in life, the easiest thing to give up is our ministry to the Lord. Amen. Real servants are faithful to their ministry. Imagine an organization, an office, or a company. Every week, people are leaving. Every week, staff are leaving. Every week, officers are leaving and quitting. What will you expect for an organization or a church or a family? What if one day, this morning, you as a dad, I don't want a dad to be dad anymore. I quit to be a dad. What will happen to your kids? What? Who will be my dad? Yung kapitbahay namin na matsungit. What if one day, I don't want to be your wife anymore. Leave me alone. You quit. I quit. Just you walk away. Kasi hindi mo nag-usol yung bigla ng kape. Sabi nyo, minsan may mag-asawa. May mag-asawa, nag-ihiwalay dahil sa toothpaste. Sa toothpaste. Yung lalaki, pag pumisa na toothpaste, sakit na. Kaya yung babae, inis na inis, galing na galing. Na doon, kinakaw sila. Anong pinagawayan nyo? Ay, doon ko sa inyo. Lagi ko, every morning, I tell my husband to do the other way. From the bottom. From the bottom. Squeeze the toothpaste from the bottom, not in the middle. They're fighting for that. Some couples are fighting for the tissue. Paano ba ikabit sa ano ba yung ano? Pag ano ba yung plant, yung fly or ilalim? They're fighting because of the tissue. Small things sometimes are issue. In the church, sometimes they're fighting. What's the color of the uniform? Oh, somebody wants red, somebody wants white, somebody wants black. Take the color. It's okay, take the color. What kind of food we serve? People are just walking out because of that. Small things sometimes, a big issue when it comes to commitment. We easily give up because of certain small issues. But sometimes we honor their major issues that you have to consider. And I don't know where you are now right now, serving God. As real servants, as we talk about, they are faithful to their ministry. Can you ask the person next to you? Can I count on you? Come on. Can I count on you? Okay. Can you reply back? Come me in. Come on. Count me in. For those of you guys, for those of you who are just, you know, new to the church, the church, I believe, is very much welcome in having you on board serving the Lord. Amen. It's just a matter of willingness and being having a servant heart. That's the test. That's the test. God is testing our faithfulness as servants. And then God will say to you, Matthew 25, verse 23, well done, my good and faithful servant. You have been faithful in handling this small, see? God is concerned in small amount. So now I will give you many more responsibilities. I don't want more. That's why I'm not going to serve even the smallest things, because that's the start. No. Start small things that God will promote you. Amen. Who can give a hand to the Lord God? It is God who promotes. It is not us who promotes themselves. Oh, I'm the one who donated this drop set. I'm the one who made these things possible. Eh, di ikaw na. Eh, di wow. Servants don't promote themselves. accept appreciation, applaud, but they point it back to God. Amen? After you sing, then some people will approach you. Hey, you sing well. You have a nice voice. Oh, thank you. Managba nga eh. Hindi pa nga ka na mag-practice. When somebody applaud you, when somebody tell you you're good, what do you say? Syempre. You say, thank you. But it's for the glory of God. Amen? It's for the glory of God. I was able to do it because of God. Maintain low profile. That's the real servant. Real servants maintain a low profile. They don't promote themselves. And Paul exposed this attitude when he talked about the Pharisees. The Pharisees, they prayed outdoor, corner street. They shout there, they pray, they heal the sick because they want appreciation and applaud from the crowd. So, and Jesus hated this attitude. And he warned, he said, when you do good deeds, listen, when you do good deeds, don't try to show off. You won't get a reward from your Father in heaven. When you did something to God or anything to your service to your brothers and sisters, you don't promote it. You don't show off. Because definitely you will receive appreciation. The Bible says, so when you receive the reward here, you will never receive. That's why your servants harvest this. They act. They don't show off. Mostly they are, people behind the scene. Sino natuloy dito? Ewan ko nga eh. We don't know. There's somebody gave this, but she doesn't want to mention her name. Yeah. Somebody will give to the church. I will name this, but please don't tell. Some people will ask, oh, what do you need? Okay, I will go to your church and I will show up. And before I give my donation, can you please call my name and just I'll go up and share something? There are some people like that. But listen, what we have really is from God. Whatever we have. You are the smartest person in this crowd. Your mind was created by God. It is from the Lord. Amen. So nobody can boast. And Jesus hated that attitude. Number eight, the last. This is my last point. Just want to call heaven. It says here, real servants don't serve for the approval. Paul said, if I were still trying to please people or please men, I wouldn't be a servant of Christ. And you know one thing about even churches like us? Pastor Sam, when he was assigned as a missionary assistant here, I was happy. I saw him when he was young, and he was at that. I was the youth pastor back then, and he was very, very young. And my wife was part of the program. She was the head of the program. They're the ones helping my wife and the kuyas, and he is one of a kind. I can say his dedication, his commitment, Actually, I was not surprised because I knew that he was prepared by God for this position. He's not perfect. I'll tell you, he's not perfect. But the way God formed him, trained him, who would have thought that as young as he is, he can pastor a church like you guys, who are, some of you are more experienced, some of you are more talented, some of you are more competent than him. But the way you treat him, the way you look up to him, the way you give honor and attention to his need, that is something. Because what you do to him is what you do to God. The Bible says what you do the least of men. When you give water, cold water, you give him. When you visit those who are in prison, you visited me. When you help those who are weak, you are helping me. So today, Pastor Sam and all the pastors and ministers who are serving the Lloydminster, we honor you today. We thank you for your service. And those of you who are leaders of the church, we thank you for your service too. And we honor you. We are all servants here. It's just a title, but we are all servants. And as Paul said, Pastor Sam, don't serve for the approval of people. Serve because God is the one who deserves your service and your ministry. And all of us as are like that. We should look at it as God is looking at you as a servant. Joseph is an example. He didn't draw attention to himself. He served Potiphar. He served the wine tester. He was in prison. He served the baker. And at the end, God promoted him. He served even his brothers who disowned him, who sold him, who rejected him as a brother. Sometimes it's hard to serve a person who rejected you, a person who hurt you, a person who doesn't like you. It's true that even if you're a good pastor, no, even some or one big person, two people might not like you, might not like what you, how you run the church. But don't look at it. Don't be discouraged. Use it for you yourself to improve. When you hear things that talks about your performance or performance as a servant, don't fight back. What you do is serve God well with what you have. And God, if you change our life, our heart, everything will change. So Pastor Sam, thank the Lord for your ministry. I praise God for what you're doing in the ministry. And for all the leaders, keep doing what you're doing. Bless the Lord. Let's all stand and pray to the Lord our God. At this moment, I want you to close your eyes and just talk personally to God. Firstly, we want to thank the Lord for all the parents who are here. Thank you for your being a servant to your family. You deserve to be honored and acknowledged because you're the head of your family. You're not perfect, but God put perform well in the name of the Lord. Those leaders, the LCC, the local church council, as you stand today, give your heart to God continuously. Bless the Lord with your talents. To those who are volunteers, those who are playing the music for the church, those who are serving the food, those who serve the kids, teaching the kids, those who go out for a mission, those who organize small groups to lead them, we honor you and thank you for your service. And may the Lord bless your heart. And today we honor Pastor, another pastor, I forgot his name. Thank you for your service. Salamat po for Pastor Este. We are so honored and blessed with your ministry. Thank you. And today, Father, we are standing in your presence as your servants. There's only one person to be honored, not us, but you. So Lord, may you receive our worship, our thanksgiving, and appreciation for all the things that you're doing in our lives, in our ministry, into this church. I pray, Father, that you open doors of opportunities for the church to grow, expand the territories, and make a great impact in the community. And that people will say and shout, "The Lord of Iron Lloydminster is truly alive and truly great." May your name be glorified in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior. And everybody say, amen, amen, and amen. May the Lord bless you this morning. God bless you.